Mr. Bobby Parker.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, thank you very much. I have got, let's see what I've got. The first thing is your collection rate. This was done on the 20th, and we have, for 2012, we have 20.25%. We're up to 30.16 now, so we've had quite a nice growth in the last 10 days. So this is what we have as of Friday, end of the month. Any questions on that information?
Within these documents, Bobby, you got a summary for the real and personal property tax in 2011.
Yes.
Vehicle tax for yes. 2011 and combined
yes, sir.
Totals for 2011. When might you be starting to run something like that for 2012?
State that question again, Mr. Glenn.
When would you be starting to run that same spread number for 2012? In other words, I see.
We should start that in the next. Well, we've already started a little bit on it, but the
it just wasn't included in our.
No, it was not all of it. No. Okay. We should have that started because being the 4 months behind. We should have that next month.
Okay. Thank you.
Your motor vehicles right now are 4 months behind. Why they hadn't been built. Right. I have a solid waste issue. I don't know if Mr. Johnson's here yet. I think you had this, not in December, November. We're in November. October, I guess it was. He has the two houses on one lot. One is his house, and one was a carriage house. He called it a carriage house. It's a livable dwelling. It's hooked to electricity. It's hooked to water, and it has its own septic system. So,
does it have a separate meter?
Yes, sir.
It has a separate meter.
I think we have the documentation where you'll approve this back in 1994. State and residents shall be charged with solid waste. You have that in your packages, section 4.
Should we wait until Mr. Johnson's here to hear him on this issue?
I've called him, and I told him somewhere around 5:30 might come on in. So you wait on that one. I'll be here.
Okay, we'll wait for that particular item. You don't have anything else, do you?
I've got the update to the drainage.
Okay.
Let's see, I think it was November the 5th, at 11 o'clock, we just had Mr. Woodruff, County Manager, Mr. Billy Mayo, Mr. Rodney Woolard, and Shirley Ann Phelps and myself. We met to discuss the land drainage and to go over it again. And I think the only thing that we've come up with that we're only going to do what we do, we're only going to do it for the commissioners that has asked to request the Board of Commissioners to show it on the tax notices. We're not going to do everyone because some of them we don't have any information from. I've talked to our programmer. He says he thinks it can be done. And I told him I think Shirley Ann has electronic format. He's coming in next week to talk to her. They're going to sit down and talk about this. Some other matters we're talking about, if there's any liens on this property, does the drainage districts want to go back and pursue the liens? And that would mean foreclose the property, garnish wages, freeze bank accounts. I think that's about what we discussed on that.
Are they willing to pay their fees for that? See, we're not gonna take this on and then pay $500 or $600.
That was one of the. I don't think we ever settled anything on that either.
There's nothing specific, Mr. Richardson, that requires them to pay a fee.
But there's something specific on our side. We've got the tax collection system, and we don't have to do this unless they're willing to come to some kind of economic terms with us.
I believe we found that the statute states if they desire to have it done, we have to do it.
But it doesn't say that we have to do the foreclosure. It says we have to collect, we have to list and collect. As I recall, the statute does not require us to do foreclosures for them free of charge.
If we did a foreclosure, Mark Bedell would do the foreclosure. He'd get paid for it.
So the property owner is going to pay them, so we don't have...
You'd be paying for the foreclosure, yes, the property owner, if that's the way we go.
All right, as long as that's clearly understood that we're not taking these people to raise.
All it says in the statute is collect. That's all it says.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, you know, I don't want to get into that trap where we're getting beat up for that money.
Just to collect it, we've definitely got to take their assessment rolls and put it on the tax notice when it goes out. So, and I talked to my finance technician this afternoon, and we went over a couple of things. Is how we're going to get it, because it says it's credit to the district in which the land is located. It's deposit to the credit. Whether we go in and we just, when we collect it, deposit right straight to the bank in the name of the drainage district or where the... I don't think it would come through finance, would it?
Yeah, it would.
It would? Okay.
Well, another thing, Bobby, is the IT committee's looking at new tax software and comparing it with your present software and looking at the possible purchase of software, and it could be some of this stuff we're looking at could handle that very easily, whereas what we have now will not handle it.
It might not do as good because he knows what we need.
I can't imagine that because of the platform you're on. It's just so obsolete, and there's just so much automation to be had nowadays. I think it would make it a whole lot simpler.
Okay. Commissioner Richardson.
How are you going to decide when to foreclose? Who's going to make that decision?
Well, there's a lot of it out there now. Hasn't been collected in the last few years.
That's not what I ask. Who is going to make the decision to foreclose? Are you going to make it? Is the district going to make it? I don't want the county to make that decision because it's not our money. You come along here, you foreclose on somebody for $400, and you pay $600 to the contractor for foreclosing. I see problems here.
Well, I see problems too. I mean, that's what we need to be very careful to not to rush into this thing. And I told Shirley Ann the other day, this is something that might not happen this year. It might take a couple of years to get these problems. There's a lot of problems with this.
I don't have a problem with us doing it, but I think we're going to have a written agreement with each one of the districts, right?
I think we need to set an established policy that governs the value of the amount, whether it's worth our while to foreclose to collect a $200 debt. We certainly don't want to pay $600
illegally. Whether it's worth their while to collect or not. But I think to protect the county's interest on this, somebody with that drainage district should authorize in writing the foreclosure.
But it says the amount shall be collected by the county tax.
No, wait a minute. You guys are playing games on this. I'm here looking after the county's interest.
Well,
I'm not looking after some statute somewhere with somebody interpreting it. You know, we're in a negotiating position on this thing. And I don't think we should foreclose on any of these drainage districts. Should be in the agreement that the drainage district is going to authorize us to foreclose. Then, if you come up with a negative amount, and we've been into these things, you can go through bankruptcies, and there could be no money there when you get there. The things can happen. So I want the drainage district to say foreclose, and then when you come up and the judges and the lawyers say, gee, guys, there's no money there today, we're going to say write us a check for our lawyer fees because we did not take this on ourselves. We're taking on a risk for somebody else, and we don't want to do that.
This is why I'm here stating that every item in this needs to be a policy set that we're going to do it this way on all of them.
You're using the wrong words again, okay. Bobby. We want a contract agreement, not a policy.
Okay, a contract agreement, but the contract would have to be the same for all four districts we're doing. So that's what I'm saying. It needs to be one way.
Right. I agree. We need a contract, not a policy.
Bobby, Randall, there's a whole lot of complexity to this. As far as being able to present this to us right now, Bobby's really not ready to present it.
I'm not.
And what we need is to have a proposal put together that covers our concerns, and I believe Hood's right about the contract. Somebody needs to put all this together and present it to us so we have something to talk about.
I see a lot of problems every time I pick this up. There's a lot of problems out there because you've got to...
You don't have nothing right now.
Didn't we charge the manager and the attorney and lobby with bringing us something in? We said in writing.
Tonight, this is just meant to be an update tonight.
Oh, okay. We are working on this, yeah.
Not the full resolution. We're still working on it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right.